Right, so as you guys know, I'm waiting until Yachty and Albert are out of the game to pop open my Sig packs because I have duped them like so many times. But luckily, this club member who I sometimes shoot videos for, JPax290, has let me in to open his Sig pack. So shout out to him. We are gonna first open any vintage packs he may have. He has a Black Diamond change ticket, Legend change ticket, 160 skill change tickets, blues, greens. He's got everything we need. So we're gonna do everything we need to do to make this new Sig good if we get something good. He also has the coins for a craft and the other cards for a craft. We have everything we need here. So let's just go for it. Let's start with the Sig pack. See if we get a random Dodger. That's the place to start. There was a diamond pull, diamond Dodger. That would be awesome. Let's just open them one at a time. First ones first. Ryan Howard 15. That's a nice card. Pujols should have won MVP in 2006, but that's fine. Chan Ho Park, LA Dodgers. What is up? That's awesome. It's not a card that's going to be replacing anybody in his lineup, but that is a club craft, and we're going to do that before we open up the Sig pack, just so that we can make an educated guess on, whether we go pitcher or batter. And then finally, a Trot Nixon 2003, great card for a Boston deck. Let's see. Let me take a snip of that. I don't think that Park will make his lineup though. I mean, it's fine, but it's probably better than the Derek Lowe that he has. Like if we go and take a look at his lineup. Derek Lowe is 71, that's a base 72. The distro is, This row's okay. Let's see. So as compared to low, let me pull up the companion site just so we can compare player registry. So if you've never used the site 9innings.com, it lets you just do all kinds of things. I would totally recommend it. But let's pull up Park. Chan Ho Park. I don't know what year that is. Let me go double check. Sorry, I'm totally out of it. Let's see. Should be in team management, lineup. We can just compare them here. Basic stats. So his distribution is all to the stamina, fastball, breaking ball side of this. He has two more velocity for four less locations, so he has less stats where we want. Even though he's higher overall, it means that his grade increase is going to go to stamina. It's going to go to fastball. So he's harder to get a fin train on. We already have Derek Lowe done. I don't think it's worth the upgrade. Let me check with him first. I'm just making sure he's okay with me crafting him away. And if you, let's see, so one of the nice features about the 9 innings companion is that it can calculate your odds for Team Select Sig. So these are his that we see pulled up here. So it tells what you'd be happy with, what you'd be not, it'd be a good card, but maybe not the best version. And what would be sad, you just plug in all that data up here. It gives you your odds for you. That's really nice. And you can see he has slightly better batter odds and pitcher odds, but it's really not that different. But if we end up pulling something here and we can, you know, let's say we get a batter, then it may be a good idea to go pitcher. So that's what I'm thinking we do. I think it's definitely the right call because Park is good. This is Park 98, but it's not, you know, if you're looking at a Dodgers deck, they have Max Scherzer, they have Tony Gonsolin, they have Walker Buehler. He doesn't have one of those. All those guys would fit right in up here. So he has a backup Kershaw, and not the best version of Kershaw either. Let's see. Yeah, Kershaw 12. You know, if we compare the Kershaws that he has, Kershaw 20 is kind of underrated. Like, it's not the base 77 Kershaw, you know, his MVP years 15, 16. But it is a very, very good card. So, you know, it's not the world beater, but it is a good card. So let's club craft that first. Team Sig Paxi. He has so many club coins. What the heck? Let's see. Kershaw 1. Park 2. Easy money. Alright. Craft these. Goodbye. We didn't do Quo. Didn't want to, because he has a Quo in backup, but he has. So the Quo Sig is slightly better than the Prime. But the Prime at Black Diamond is only slightly worse, so it's like we'd rather spend resources elsewhere. Alright. LA Dodgers Sig Pack. Let's see what we get. So this one. Give me something good. It's a good batter. It's solid. It has good distribution. He already has one. Two in a row. Max Muncy. So, unlucky. Unlucky, unlucky. So, okay. That's fine. We still got this. So I'm thinking, again, looking at these, you know, batter's slightly better for him to go. But I want to go pitcher just because he can upgrade part of that rotation. He doesn't have any Sig RPs. You know, if he lands Scherzer in there, Ryu, Walker Buehler, Gonsolin, you know, he can upgrade off of that Derek Lowe. In batter, he does have a couple holes to fill, but I feel like his pitching needs are a lot more. You know, just here, let me go back. I mean, his biggest needs are these guys right here. He said he'd be happy with a Gagne Sig, even though he has this beast in there. Bullpen day, touch. Touch isn't greatest on a bullpen, but, you know, this card doesn't matter. It's awesome. But he can replace any one of these guys with a good Team Sig pitcher. So that's where I'm going to go. National League. We're not Cardinals. We are Dodgers on this account. Don't want to open up a Cardinals. Let's see what happens. We're going to go pitcher. I think it's the right call. Because he does have batters he could upgrade. I think pitcher's the call. It's Jerry Royce. It's got to be. That's not. Look at those stats. That's not what we want. Even if it's not Jerry Royce, it's like Todd Leary or whatever his name is. That's not an upgrade. Jerry Royce. Oh, gosh. Oh, well, I guess we have a club craft in a month. So I'm going to tell him that. Man, especially because Jerry only has one card in the game, you know? I am unhappy with that. Makes me think I should have gone batter. But you know what? I think no. Process was good. Process was good. A batter had slightly better odds, but like these cards here are fine. Especially like Kemp, one of the ones he could replace is running bad ball hitter, barrel it up, right? Turner, spotlight, slugger, instinct, prediction with some pretty good stats already mixed out. Machado, similar idea, you know. Like, yeah, you can do better than these, but you need to do better than these. So, all right, that's where I'm going to call it for now. Let's move on to some skill changes and see if we can't improve this team that way. Let's get right to it. All right. So, like I said, he has a Kenley to replace his current one. Man, I can't get over that bad Sig pack look. Ugh. So this is a good year, Jansen. I don't think it's his best, but it's insanely good. So we want to get this in there over that Kenley, because if you just compare him, he's better straight up and down the board. So that's what we're going to work on first. That's what we're going to work on first. Let's just see how it goes. So Kenley 16. Alright. Where is Kenley Jansen? There we go. Nothing there worth keeping. We got 150 of these. Hopefully luck is better today. We're just going to kind of play it by ear. He has his current Kenley is in a middle relief role. So fin touch instantly. That's good. We want three skills though. And on 150 of these tickets, we could probably do better, right? Like that's the goal is to, well, okay. Let me show you what he has and we can talk through my thought process. Like all of these guys are pretty solid on skills. Nothing skill change tickets could do better. 333s, BBH, spot slug, BBH, slug MBT. So like maybe one day a higher level set, but you know, spot BBH, MBT again, higher level set could do better. Slugger car, car BIU, slugger spot, you know, like we could do better there. Matt Kemp, BBH barreled up, right? Like that's fine. Then Justin Turner, spot slug prediction. So like batting lineup for like maybe these guys could do better, and we might circle back around to them if we hit on Kenley. Also, let me check. We were talking about the 9 innings companion. Let me check the best Kenley years. His prime is really good. I don't know, after yesterday, if he's ever going to buy a TSS again, right? So, let's see here. We got Dom Fin Touch. Like, this should be really good. Does he get Fin plus 7, plus 4, plus 5? So, yeah, he gets Fin. He gets Fin. I kind of want to make him Black Diamond just because it'd look hot. I don't think we're going to be GIing that Kuo. Obviously, work on these stats. Finn Boss could be better, or we're going to be working on this guy anyway. Avilon, Fixer, Finn Boss, he gets Finn bonus plus, yeah, he gets Finn bonus somewhere in there. Minus 3 plus 19, so yeah, he gets Finn bonus, and David Price is his LR. So, I think Kuo wants to be our next Black Diamond, and then obviously Bullpen Day Touch. So yeah, it's worth it to go for a 3-skill set on Jansen. If it ends up with Fixer in it, you know, that's fine. We can plug him in middle relief. If it ends up with, like, a really strong 3-skill set, we can move Kuo down to MR and keep using Jansen. So, skill change tickets. And I'm just excited, guys, because I haven't done this kind of video in forever. Let me tell you, this whole waiting for Yachty and Albert to be out of the game thing, it's driving me crazy. It's driving me crazy. I love making these videos and just with nobody to work on and trying to save my resources. You know, I encourage people to play smart on this channel, right? Like that's what I want. I want you guys to play smart MLB 9 innings. Setup man, Finn 333. We're gonna keep the 3-3-3s, keep the already better set to try to get him in. I don't. Let me check. Wait, the only way I keep these is if this is his best year and if it's better than his prime year, is the only way I keep this. So let's go to the companion. Let's go to LA Dodgers. We can type in we want Kenley Jansen. Positions all selected. It's whatever. Because it's just going to filter by Dodgers. So A over, it kind of calculates their stats, filtering by what's best, you know, versus their typical over. It has a little bit of a weakness where, like, typically you want cards with higher batting stats or higher Loken-Vell, and A over will just, if you have like a higher stamina and a lower Loken-Vell, but the stamina is much higher, it'll tell you that that card's much better. So there's a little bit of a weakness in there. So just like if you have two cards that are close by A over, compare them in the collections. You know, we can go here and pull up, man, so many Sigs. Go pull up all of the Jansen years. See, Trinan. Where are we? Come on, Kenley. Baez has so many years. Holy cow. Jansen. Yeah, see, so like 16 is what he has. Okay, that's great. 17, slightly worse. Oh, no, it's slightly better. But, well, okay, so yeah, see here, like this one, definitely a higher A over card, and it's probably a better card, and it's easier to train for Finn. But this one has slightly higher left side stats at the cost of a lot of break, right? So, like, 17 is a really good one. 18 is way worse. 13 is worse. 14 is worse. 15 is worse. 19 is worse. 20, worse. 21. Okay, so this is like one of the two Jansen cards that we'd probably want. And then we can go up and we can check the prime. And the prime, we can actually filter. We can filter by primes. There we go. Yeah, 17. It's that card. So this could be improved if he got his prime, you know, or any one of the Sigs. But this is definitely one worth getting a three skill set on, because it'll perform very, very well, even if it's not the final best, greatest year ever. So probably won't be using greens on it to try to land a 3-3-3 set. We're going to save those for good legend sets. And the other thing we can do is he's trying to push for diamond right now. So he's sitting gold 2. He usually ends up around gold 1. Power ranking. Yeah, so he's 857, so he's got a little bit of pushing to go to start getting up here, but I think he can do it. One of the things when you're trying to climb power rankings, just look at your stats. Let's start by pitchers. Who are his worst pitchers? So Clayton Kershaw's doing great. No sub 1 ERA starting pitchers, which is probably really the thing that's holding him back. Royce, we've already talked about retraining for Dom. I'm going to knock that out today. Are there any starters down here? No. See, Jansen's not doing great. We're going to fix that. Gagne is not doing great with a 3.86 ERA. Urias is okay. Fine with the rest of his bullpen up here. Lowe's doing solid, but could be replaced, as we said. Granke, Hill, Kirsch. So, work to go. And we can look at the batters too. And I can already tell you that his three non-Sig legend batters are going to be worse. So, like, okay, so power of legends. Look at this. Carew is absolutely blowing his other cards out of the water. His Carew is ranked 341 in terms of power ranking. So I'm gonna, also as green is getting at bats, as his batter's chem guy, he doesn't have batter's chem yet, or pitcher's chem yet, but he does have batter's chemistry on green. Kemp isn't doing great with BBH, BIU. I'm not shocked. It's why I was kind of tempted to go replace Kemp with some other DH. Yeah, and then Turner. Bellinger's actually pretty low down. Bellinger could use either a legend skill or a better. Skill set because he just has car BIU. Let's get this Jansen to a point. Well, this Jansen can go in now with Fin Touch. We're gonna leave him. We're gonna switch over to Cody. And we're just gonna blow some on these, kinda hunt for a three skill set. BIU spot is already gonna be better than car BIU. And he already gets the bonus. Good stats here. Typically for BIU bonus, you can see his eye is kind of low, but with BIU bonus, you really want as much contact as possible. And speed is good too. So I want to keep BIU spot. We're going to max that out while we hunt on this set. Man, started out with double gold, but laser beam prediction 1-1-1. Not what we want. 3-3-2. I wouldn't mind 3-3-3s on this guy, if we ended up with a good set to look for a 3-3-3 skill set on. Double golds, double, not great. Car 5 tool with highish levels. 3-1-3. We're just trying to push him over the top into Diamond 3. Like, that's what we're looking for right now. With Belly being one of his worst batters, we gotta do something better. Spot, laser beam, high levels. That was a good start, but no dice. Exhaustion. If it was 3-3-3 there, I'd probably green it, honestly. So I don't really want to use greens today. So, yeah, if you're looking to climb power ranking, just look at your stats in ranked. Like, play a lot of ranked if you're trying to climb power ranking. Even if you're losing games, like, play all that you can, except on Sunday. Sunday, try to play smart. But other than that, play every game you can and see which players are consistently doing better and which players are consistently doing worse. And then after that, make judgments on who to improve. For your batters, kind of look for home runs, who's hitting the most bombs. For pitchers, check by ERA, check by WHIP. And it's hard to see week to week for pitchers. There's a 3-3-3, not what we're looking for though. Spot prediction, full swing, man. If this was a gold skill, if this was like charisma here, ugh, that would have been so good. Or even if it was spot, charisma, some card seems to be leaning spotlight today. Pitchers, it's kind of hard to tell. You have to check over the course of multiple weeks because they might be having worse matchups based on, like your ace may be running into a bunch of 120 overall teams while your fifth pitcher is running into a bunch of 90 overall teams, right? And obviously they're the one who gets the easier matchups is going to have better numbers. So, man, come on, give me something worth keeping. 3-3-3s, but not worth keeping. So pitchers you have to check over multiple weeks, but you'll notice usually at the bottom end of your batters, that's the same week to week. And then when you see that, just pick one card that's going to be with you for a long time that's not doing well and work on improving them. Like if it's some low overall batter that you just have in there so you can get a team set deck, don't worry about blowing 100 skill change tickets trying to look for something better, right? But if it's some Sig like this and he's in, he's like the bottom of his good cards, right? So we want to improve this one, especially with having gotten that Kenley to a place where he could be put in over that other Kenley. BIU 5 tool table setter. Oh, if this was, again, if this was Slugger Instinct here, you could put this guy at leadoff and he'd smash. So. Three, 3-2 with laser beam. Oh my gosh, this game is trolling me. I don't hate reliable as a third. 3-3-2 with the triple silvers. Car, MBT, low level. Five tool with the 3-3-3. We still got 90 to go. Hopefully we get something nice. More better than BIU spot. We want three skills. But yeah, that's just how you, in general, that's how you rank up. Like, you know, say you have a not ideal skill set on, okay, so first off, if you have only one card that is like, you know, a Sig or a Legend, or maybe you have two cards that are Sigs and Legends, do everything you can to make them, quote unquote, end game. And I really have a issue with the term end game, first off. I don't think it actually exists in this game, but it keeps getting thrown out there. But make them as good as you can. You know, give them. Let's say it's a Legend starting pitcher. Get them a control master slow starter. Get them two good gold skills. Like, focus all your energy on making that card really good. So that's step one. Where was I going with this? I'm trying to talk to you guys and do this at the same time. So first off, if but oh yeah, after that, take a look at the cards in your lineup and like don't focus on making all of them super elite, you know, as soon as po or if you have the money, obviously you can buy all the stuff to make them super elite as soon as possible. But if you're running a lower spending deck, then you really want to just focus on improving the weakest links that are going to be there at a long time, one at a time. So something like I ran on my Jack Flaherty, cooperative pitcher, dominant pitcher, cleaning up your mess for a long time, and he was a solid middle of my rotation pitcher, and I hit diamond multiple times with him in my rotation. Like, I hit the power ranking tournament with that? No. But I'm not gonna hit the power ranking tournament anyway. Come on, man. I'm not gonna hit the power ranking tournament anyway. You know, I was just trying to hit diamond, and so I didn't work on improving him, even though he's a Sig starting pitcher, and he was my first Sig starting pitcher, and I love Jack Flaherty, and I want him to be good in my rotation. I didn't want, if he was performing fine, I could put those resources somewhere else, and that let me get, you know, as opposed to blowing a bunch of premium skills on him, I was able to get batter's chemistry, I was able to get pitcher's chemistry, and those had a much bigger impact on my starting pitching rotation, in my batting lineup than just a better set on Jack Flaherty. Man, this is trolling me, man. It's giving me like two, it's giving me a third skill and a top line starter skill, and then nothing. Like charisma here, that'd be great. So this game is being rude. So just focus on who's not performing for you and make them better before you focus on, unless you have a true end game card, focus on making the weakest link better and you'll see yourself start to climb ranks, right? You won't see yourself end up in the power ranking tournament. Again, that's like a whole different subject for discussion. Trolled. That's a whole different subject for discussion, but just improve. Improve one at a time. And that's how I saw myself get better, you know, start climbing up the ranks. So it's also you're remember you're in an arms race with oh my God, guys, that came off the rip, off the skill change ticket. What? Let me message this dude. What? I have never seen that. Oh, I think Fireballs had a video like 6 months ago where he had this like a set like this end up 3-3-3 off the rip. What the Makes me want to retrain him. Like go for look at his power. Look at this. Oh, this card is gonna be great. Makes me want to retrain him though. Go for less speed field. If I get bored, so I'm filming this on New Year's Eve day. If I'm bored New Year's Day and can't, I can't really do much, I might work on retraining this if he'll let me. Well, that solves that. We got what we needed. All the trolling paid off. Charisma Spotlight barrel it up. Jeez. Okay, back to Jansen. We also have premiums and legendary skill change tickets. Again, I JPax dude, if you're watching this video, I'll let him claim all that. If you're watching this video, dude, thanks for letting me do this. I've been going crazy with not being able to do this on my account. Like, I love doing this stuff. So, insane. Insane. All right, where's my Kenley? Where is my Kenley? So we're looking at this. I don't want to use greens on it. So Finn setup man, touch isn't great in the bullpen. But Finn setup man, even if you pretty much have to put setup man in the closer role, and I know it says the setup man, but at the level he's at, he's trying to make the jump from gold one to diamond. Going 2 innings, like he will blow games with this set, right? Like he'll go 1 inning and then he'll get into the next game. And even if we struggle and we get the Finn bonus on him, which is it's not easy, right? Like he's starting way in the hole, like -7, -4, so -11 points toward Finn. So we can get a Finn bonus. He's still only gonna have Finn, and we use the 5 greens we have on this instead of on a legend set. It's just not worth it. But anyway. Back to what I was saying earlier, now that I'm back to ripping these skill change tickets, just work on improvement. Work on making your team better. Just find your weakest link, make it better. And I've said that a couple times. Just I really do think people focus way too much in on worrying about getting perfectly optimal skills. And that's important if your team, like, I don't know, AK's when he was still making videos, he's trying to compete and get into the power ranking tournament. Team like Jad as well, like his team is super high overall. He shouldn't settle for a skill like co-op because, he's competing at the highest level in one of the best clubs. But if you're just trying to improve, like set goals for yourself, you're trying to hit gold, you don't need to roll off of a high level co-op set, right? Now, there's a whole lot of other things that go into decision making. Maybe I should make a flow chart for this, and I probably won't because I don't want to, but something like if you're not buying greens, don't use greens on a co-op set, right? But if you are buying greens and you have a ton of them, use greens and get yourself a usable co-op set and move on to looking for everybody else and then come back to that later, right? Like spending 3 or 4 greens to get usable skills on your co-op set if you're buying them every couple months, But then again, if you have like 80 people to green, co-op isn't the number one skill choice. But something tells me if you have like 80 skill sets to, use greens on, you're probably not aiming for just hitting gold or whatever. So, it's another 3-3-3. We're gonna move on past this one. There's just so much context that has to go into it. It's really hard, to make decisions about people's teams without me. Without me knowing like what you're spending, what you're without me knowing like what kind of money you're spending. And without me knowing what kind of fixer income, you know, what you're buying, what your goals are. You gotta figure that out for yourself. Damn, not good. So, anyway, there's my rant. Rant over. Giant Crusher 333. Just something to do while we ripped 160 skill change tickets. Just walk through my process on this. And maybe it was a ramble. And if it was a bad rambling, oh man, if that was 333, I might consider keeping it because no, I wouldn't. I already went through the 333 thing. Just kind of a ramble. So if you thought it was rambly, then you know, tell me down below. Dom, Fixer, Firefighter, we're gonna keep in touch. Let me know down below. And I'll try to do better in the future. But if that helped you out, also let me know. Because that's what I try to do. I try to help you all out. And if you're wondering how I'm making decisions on this, you can go back and check my other skill change ticket video. There we go, Fixer Stab. Or you can go check out my bullpen skills video. It's somewhere back on my channel. I would say I'll link it below, but I'll probably forget that I said this. Like I said, I need to do better about that kind of stuff, but it's on my channel. You can scroll back. You can even filter another 333. You can even filter by guides. I have like a guides playlist, and it should be in there. So, Ace, put away. Still insane that we ripped that 333 off the skill change ticket. So, no complaining here. We can train Kenley for Finn. Dom, Finn, Firefighter. I like that better than Finn Touch. Firefighter's kind of useless, but Dom, Finn in the bullpen, it's not the best set of all time, and you really do want a third skill with it. I don't know if we'll hit one in 16 skill change tickets. But you can train for Finn bonus, and the Dom will help make up for skills you lack. And if he's going right in middle relief, this will be better than the other Kenley. So, we'll still keep looking. Like, at this point, we want triple skills. This point, we want triple skills. But we don't seem to get it. Like, give me Fixer there, and I'm super happy, right? All right, seven left. So don't know if we'll do much better than this on Kenley, but that's fine. We're happy with you know what, that skill set we landed on. Like, this is an improvement for his Kenley situation. He can work on fixing this with training. Finn PM winning streak. I don't love it. I like it better than this set if we're putting him at closer. Then you can put Gagne at setup. Yeah. We're just gonna keep these two. We'll think about it. Either way, he needs a fin training, so we know what to go. We know what direction to go from there. Okay, premium skill change tickets. He doesn't have PKEM, so we're gonna got 107 BD pieces. Got a legendary skill change ticket. I want to use this to try and improve Zach Greinke. Greinke's good, but he has a bullpen day 6-6-8. I've hated this card. Just him landing bullpen day at that high of a level, like you want to use it, but then he got Dom and everybody who watches this channel knows that I probably have an irrational hatred for Dom. Especially on cards like this, where it's like super tough to get that training that you need for it. And this card is super insane anyway, base 76. Like, I don't know. I think, in my opinion, legendary skill change tickets should be used for two things. One, chem hunting. Like, you should use it to hunt either pitcher's chem or batter's chem on good cards that you know, if you end up landing a good set on, they can make your lineup. But if you end up landing a chem on them, you're not going to replace them down the line, right? So that's how I see legendary skill change tickets should be used in one situation to hunt chem. But also, if you already have, never use them on a legend because they have higher chances of getting good skills off of premium skill change tickets, first off. But I like to use them to make good sets that are already good, just see if we have the chance to make them better. And you may end up with something like Pitcher's Insight, but I'd rather, you know, hunt for these skills on this Granky and, you know, get the chance of getting a slow starter set or a control master set than use them on someone else who I'm going to use premiums on. So that's just where I'm at. We already have this good set. Let's see if we can't make it better. Let's take the chance, okay? So, and Bullpen Day on a starter, this is another one. Like, if you roll Bullpen Day 3-3-3 on your starting pitcher, you know, and you're sitting in mid-silver and you buy greens, you know, maybe use greens on it. Try to get two skills and it'll do really well for you, or try to get three skills and it'll do really well for you for a long time, right? Like, this guy has a sub-1.5 ERA in pushing gold, from gold pushing into diamond, right? Or mid-gold one. So I'm just looking for better, though. So let's do this. Let's see what happens. Co-op, 3-1-2. Not great. That's fine. Next up, premiums. Let's use it to work on. He doesn't have pitchers worth using it on. Does it have batters worth using it on? I kind of want to use them to hunt chemistry, if I'm being honest. PChem could take them up a level. PChem could take him up a level. That Cody set is going to take him up a level, though. Yeah, I want him to use BD pieces in the bullpen. I'm going to let him make that call. So let me chat with him. Oh, we're not quite there. We're at 9 of these. And we get another premium skill change ticket on New Year's Day. Unless he has a craft. Okay, he still has a day left on that. I'm gonna chat with him. We'll see what happens. I'm wanting him to hunt for chemistry, though. I think that that's the next best, especially since he didn't get a batter from this. I would have used him on, like, or a pitcher. If he got a new starting pitcher, I would have used him there. So just looking through the rest of his lineup, retrain, maybe blues, kind of low levels for blues, but I don't hate it. He doesn't have the Dom training, but we're gonna have to retrain that. You know, like I said, co-op, Dom, mess, you know, Rich Hill's going to do fine for Diamond. Like, it's one of those, you could do better, right? Like, this is exactly what I ran on my Flaherty, and he was like a mid pitcher in my lineup, right? He wasn't quite up there with my aces, like Nolan, who was running Control Master, Dom, mess, right? But he was mid. Jerry Rice, do I use blues? Golden pitcher sucks. How many blues do we have? Don't want to use them all. We got 6. Slow is one of those you can short too. Let's just use a couple. Let me make sure this is blue, right? Okay, yes. Setup man ain't gonna do it. Oh, baby. Now, some people are going to be like, hey, you shouldn't use blues on a set below level 4. But he's not trying to make the tournament. This set, you short slow, this set is going to be freaking killer. Now, of course, I could have hit nothing, right? That's part of the risk. Is always there's always a risk of hitting nothing, but with this legend set, with slow starter, like to me, that's worth using blues on. And that means I don't have to retrain for Dom. I'll still have to retrain. I'll still have to retrain. But that should be an improvement. Kenley should be an improvement. I'm just going to send him. Man. Okay. Well, the only thing I'm debating now is where to use those premiums and that legend ticket that he's gonna get. So I'm probably gonna come back and do those a little bit later. Overall, improvements in skills are here. And he improved his skills. That's what we're looking for. Unfortunately, the Sig didn't work out. So, yeah, I'm kind of out of things to say, if you couldn't tell. Thank y'all for watching. Let's go figure out this premium situation. All right, so last part of this. So, we made a decision. I chatted with him. We are going to Black Diamond Evan Phillips to hunt for pitcher's chemistry. He needs it. Phillips only has one Sig. If he lands bullpen day or something, it can be a really good Sig for him. So that's what we're looking at. Evan Phillips, base 68, just great stats overall. Hard to get a fin train on. Didn't mean to do that. Hard to get a fin train on, but that's not the end of the world. Hard to go wrong with a base 68 reliever, even if he has a bit of fastball and stamina. The only way you don't love that is if he has like 60 or 60 plus stamina, then your other stats are going to really suffer. But this is more than fine. Really need 58 pieces for it, so let's send it. Oh, yeah, we need 58 full pieces. That's what happens when you use like a gold player to. Yeah, that's what happens when you use a gold player to upgrade, is sometimes you get that little half a piece. Okay, so he's upgraded. Let's PChem hunt. Let's see what we can get. We got 10 of these premiums, and then we're gonna get a legend ticket, and we're gonna use that on. Oh, I want to use it on Granky again. All right, Phillips. And his set. Another reason I chose him is his set. He has Fin Fixer, which is pretty good. But I wouldn't mind getting a better one for him. Fixer put away. That's a 3-3-3 over there, but we don't really care about that. Fin Fixer's better, and we're not going to use greens. Pitcher's Insight, sad. Sure, let's keep it. Why not? Why not? Alright, next up. Touch, Iron Will. Keep our favorite skill. 1, 2, 3, pass. Alright, six more to go. Boss Fin, we'll keep that. Reverses Fin Fixer, you know, it's kind of six one way, half dozen the other. Probably Boss Fin is a little bit better. You might say, well, Boss might run into nerfs. Well, fun fact. People have started nerfing Fixer now too, especially higher overall teams. Boss touch 1-1-1, pass. Two left, then we get the legend ticket. Fin Giant Crusher, and finally, our last one. Nothing. Okay. So, legend skill change ticket has been sent to an inbox. Okay, so we retrained Jerry Royce for the new set. Really sick train here. Pitcher. Look at that beaut. That's a velocity one fin train on him. Perfectly gets the bonus. All his numbers are red, which is I always think is so pretty. We went fin 8, dom 7, slow starter 3. And you can do that. Slow starter doesn't need to be maxed if you have two other good skills and it's at least level 3. That's because slow starter, it's still going to max out at the same stats and it's still going to gain the same like per every couple pitches. It's just it's going to start out a little bit lower, I believe. So he'll be a little bit weaker in the first inning, but I think that the dom being higher will make up for that. And then later in the game, when slow would be equally as good, dom 3 versus dom 7 is a huge difference. So that's why we did that on Jerry Royce. Let's take a look at some stats real quick. Just who to use that legend change ticket on. Pitchers by ERA. Because if Greinke's killing it, I mean, Greinke's doing good. Royce is going to jump up here. Hill's doing fine. We could just use it on Phillips. You know? He does need more bullpen pieces. That's another one of his weaknesses, is bullpen. Man, I want like 8 of these things, you know? Because I do want to do better on Greinke. I do want to turn him into that high-end starter, but that's not what he needs right now. Pitcher's chemistry would really help set him up, like a lot, a lot. Man, it's a tough call, and I can go wrong. You know? That Greinke card is just so good. And it deserves to really have an amazing set. Whereas Phillips, I mean, if I got pitcher's chemistry and I went on Greinke, I would be so pissed. If I got like slow starter, I mean, it's a win lose, you know? It's like it just depends on the outcome. But if Greinke's already doing fine and he needs bullpen help, I think the answer has to be Phillips, especially with pitcher's chem on the table, because he doesn't have it yet. And pitcher's chem would take his deck a huge, huge step up. It helps with everybody's deck, but if he's already borderline, at least pushing toward diamond, pitcher's chemistry can often put you over the top in close battles. It can help out his bullpen. It can help out his starters, right? That's what we're gonna do. We're just gonna hunt for PKM. Praying here. Ah, 213 slow starter. Okay, so actually, I've run slow starter fixer before in the bullpen, and it kind of worked. It you have to run it in middle relief, and it's not the best, but I've done it. I did it on my Al Hobrosky. Eventually, I had to move past it, but it's not the worst middle relief set. So, especially paired with fixer, that's what makes me think it works fine in middle relief. And the reason is middle relief can go like middle relief can go like 3 or 4 innings or 3 innings, and slow starter can really get rolling by the end of that, and fixer helps it get over its first inning woes. So I might train him for slow starter fixer, have him max that out, and just call it a day there. So thank you all for watching. Happy New Year. Lots of stuff happened this video. I'm glad I was able to make a video like this. It's been a long time since I have. But I'm super happy to, you know, be able to put out a Sig video. So shout out to JPax for letting me use this deck. I really do appreciate it. You guys have a great new year. Let 2023 be everything you hoped it could be. Yeah, I think that's just about gonna do it. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for the subs. Leave a like, comment below, and I'll try to get back to it. I'll talk to y'all. next week.